started to introduce the carbon market. So, no, please. So, what I expect that you learn from the carbon market? First, what is carbon finance? And what, first of all, what you trade? And are you allowed to trade? This is the question. So origin of the environmental markets, how this idea happened? From where? How was its performance about the initial demonstration project? And what is the difference between cap and trade and carbon taxation? At the end of the day, the government has to decide. Government has the power to decide how the players work, yes? How the governments administrate the game. So at the end of the day, the governments are regulators that create the game and try to... You have that your company is growing in some slow, and the issue is that you implement a project and you decrease the business as usual. Yes? So, and what emissions we are talking about? We are talking about these six kinds of gases, greenhouse gases. So this is the concept of business as usual. And what you trade? So you have a project that happened, that you prepared this project, and you have to look for the way to monetize. The government create this environment that you could monetize this emissions. So you are trading something called ton CO2 per year. What is your currency? Is that? This is the currency. You will trade either CERs and VERs. All this we will explain later. What does it mean, and also the differences between CERs and VERs. So how this idea of the carbon market appear in US? It was an original US idea. They started to work on the power sector. EPA create, there were an act, an federal act that allows EPA to create a market of sulfur dioxide and nitrous dioxide. These emissions create the problem of the acid rain. So all the power sector at that time, you have to think that there were a petroleum shock in 1973. So all the US generators started to use coal because there were a problem in Iran. The main source of oil, and the government noticed that. Sorry, the lakes, the rivers started to be acid because these emissions of SOx and NOx. So the Clean Act create some targets, some caps for the power sector. And these are the caps. So what was the effectivity, the performance of this? As you can see, the slope going up was the electricity and heat. And the slope going down were the SOX and NOX. That means, despite all the years happened, yes, the system worked in U.S. So they were this idea. Origin of the environmental markets. Okay, sorry. Cap and trade. So this is an election from the government. But you said, what government? Is Jamaica government could select that? No. No, is other governments. But Jamaica could accompany other governments in some way. For instance, through bilateral treaties and so on. As you can see, the election is from the government. The decision to regulate is from the government. The governments deploy regulation, organizing the game, and putting rules for the different players. So the operations are private, public, owned, but regulated by the government. I will talk later what government is that. cap and trade regulation fundamentals. This is the element that is necessary to administrate a cap and trade. So you need a central authority, that is the government, that set up a limit or permits emissions. So this is the idea of cap. And then the players that the government invite to play are doing the trade. So, or to be more precise, the players that are authorized by the government could play. So, also, simultaneously, there were other weather environmental considerations on trading. For instance, all for agricultural, this started early at the beginning of 900s. This is coming from New York. The New York Stock Exchange was created according to this. They started with a market of butter. Strange, but. In 2000, Enron came and created a mega trading system where every company, every power company had to sell to Enron, and Enron said, for instance, to California, and Enron created a lot of money for them. So. Other weather environmental tool was also forecasting the weather. So the power injected in the grid had some constraints that are related, for instance, in a big grid, you have constraints related to storms, electrical storms, because they destroy some lines. Then it's necessary each time that they are doing a simulation, generate or create some insurance about the weather. Yes, and so on. Also the customer demands, because if the customers are linked to the weather, for instance, in America or in Europe, when it's quite cold, they consume more fuel. Then there's not fuel available for power plants. So this is an idea about cap and trade. Right now, what is carbon taxation? It's simple. It's a tax. So the guy, the CEO of Exxon said, I don't like